Hey, what's going on, Guardians? TBL here, back with the full guide for how you can get your hands on the Year 3 exotic auto rifle, the Necrochasm. This gun is back in a big way, and it's way more accessible than it's ever been. Now, first things first, you're gonna have to have yourself the Husk of the Pit white common weapon that only drops from Hive enemies. You can get the drop from a variety of Hive, although we do have a video showing how to effectively farm them out to get the drop in the easiest way possible. If you haven't seen it, there will be a link in the description for you to go and watch it and get full details there. But once you've got your Husk of the Pit, you're ready to go ahead and get started. Now, first things first, there are basically three different types of husks that we'll be dealing with, and the difference is in the perk Cannibalism that will be found on all of them. The Cannibalism perk will ask you to use the gun to defeat certain mobs of Hive, Thralls, Wizards, or Knights, and which one you get will determine what you need to do next to farm those things out. You'll need to kill a large number of the enemy type that you've been assigned, but thankfully there are several places in the game where you can farm out each of these mobs. If you get knights, head to the rocket yards like you're seeing here. There are four knights that spawn on rotation in this area, and you can literally just make a very quick and easy to run circle, catching all of them right as they spawn. About 10 to 15 minutes of this rotation should have this step done for you. If you get thralls, well, congratulations, you got the easy one. You'll need to kill about 400 Thrall, but there are plenty of places in the game where you can get that done. One would be the first Moon Story mission, The Dark Beyond. You know, the We've Woken the Hive mission. Another choice would be Siege of the Warmind in the Cosmodrome. Both of those will have high numbers of Thralls rushing you all at once, and they're very easy to mow down. Once they've stopped spawning, just die, reset the area, and you're good to go once again. If you happen to get Wizards, it's a little bit more difficult, but there are still a few places where you can spawn them out. One would be the Moon Story mission, Chamber of Night. The final room will have 3 to 4 wizards that you can kill, wipe, and then kill again. Or you can head over to the Dreadnought and make your way over to the area with the Court of Oryx. There are a few wizards that spawn in that area that you can just jump back and forth between. By the time you killed one, the other one will have respawned. So, once you've found out which mob you need to hunt down, get to farming. It'll take you a little while to complete that step, but once you do, the next phase of this quest will start, tasking you with heading back to the tower and speaking with the speaker. This part of the quest will have you utilizing 25 motes of light to purge the corruption and darkness from the Husk of the Pit frame, transforming it into the Eidolon ally. Once you've done this, congrats, you've gotten yourself a legendary auto rifle. Now let's turn it exotic. Although interestingly enough, the perks on the Eidolon ally that you receive will be wholly dependent upon which version of the Husk of the Pit that you got. If you got the Knight version, it'll have the Knight Darkness Breaker perk as well as Glass Half Full, while the other versions for Thrall and Wizards will have stuff like Crowd Control. Just an interesting little tidbit of information there. But once you've got your Eidolon ally, head over to Eris Morn, who will task you with the final part of this quest: creating the essence of the Oversoul. Now this is going to be a three-part quest that's going to task you with doing three things: defeating Omnigul and the Will of Crota Strike for a special drop, and then taking part in the 390 version of the Crota's End raid and completing the Abyss section and destroying Crota himself. So get to work. Now the version of the Omnigul strike doesn't really matter. You can literally just go to the director and pick the level 16 version from the Cosmodrome. But for Crota, it has to be the 390 version of that raid, which means you will have to have done the weekly featured raid at least once. But once you've defeated Omnigul, traversed the Abyss, and then defeated Crota himself, head back to Eris Morn, who will complete the ritual granting you the essence of the Oversoul. Take that, apply it to the Eidolon ally, and congratulations, you will have created the Necrochasm Exotic Arc Damage Auto Rifle. So go ahead and pat yourself on the back. Thankfully, it was a lot easier this time around. But alright, Guardian, for the most part, the Necrochasm is the exact same beast that you remember. Maximum rate of fire with a surprising amount of stability. But its special ability has changed just a little bit. Rather than having to get precision shots, the Cursed Thrall Christmas Explosion will trigger on every single kill now, making it a great ad-clearing gun in PvE. But alright, that's it for this guide video, guys. Hopefully it helps some of you Guardians finally get your hands on the Necrochasm. But anyways, it's gonna be it for this one. Thanks so much for watching, and as always, I am the Black Link. You Guardians, stay frosty.